Dos. No. Toni, Jaman, what's up? Jaman, going to the club? Now? Oh no man, it's too early. Check the statistics. After 2 hours? Be there. See you soon. Skrrt! Papa!
Hello. Good evening.
Hey. How are you?
Where, bro?
How are you going?
Inside the club? Scapto Club, the best club.
It's private. Top investors private.
Right? We are top investors. I mean, me. Like that.
Wait, who are you? Who you think you are?
I'm Kering, but with Gucci, Saint Laurent.
Oh?
Uh-huh.
That's whack. Ferragamo was much better.
For what?
Ferre souffle?
Souffle, ma français?
Souffle.
Ah, but you're crazy. I never heard of that. What's that?
You're crazy. You're crazy.
I'm crazy.
But just
crazy. Okay, I'm a little bit crazy.
And what about you?
What are your
I'm
brands?
I'm Burberry. The British luxury.
You've heard of Burberry?
I've heard of Blackberry, but not of Burberry.
No. Phones? Blackberry.
The phone with the buttons?
No, we make fashion products. Cosmetics.
Oh, cosmetics.
Never heard of them.
Yeah, don't worry guys, it's obvious that we are the best. We are the LVMH. We offer like so many, like the best luxury brands. You have Celine, Louis Vuitton. And I don't see any one of you others bringing his own private bodyguard with him.
I don't need a private bodyguard, I'm a bodyguard myself. For me, myself and I. What do you think?
For how many people?
Three people.
But for three people?
Even more, because my company is so big. Top investor, Kering.
No.
This is the only thing you need to invest your money on, Kering.
Nah.
We can argue about that. What the fuck you think you're doing? Like, my company. Okay. We need to decide based on statistical data, ratios.
Okay, let's do it. Okay, all of
let's
us.
Do that.
We're doing? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. LVMH or Louis Vuitton Moët Hennessy is a French corporation which operates towards five specific categories: wild and spirits, fashion and leather goods, perfumes and cosmetics, and watches and jewelry. It consists of brands like Louis Vuitton, Celine, Christian Dior, and a lot more. The revenue of the company for the 2017 year was 42,636 million euros. Our gearing has been high. For 2017, it was 0.41, which is high. This shows us that the company just decided to aggressively finance its development through debt. Then our share performance for the last 5 years has been great, since our share prices are just going up and up. And this is because we are launching a lot of new products and opening a lot of new stores. Regarding our financial ratios, the company has been doing overall well. Our current ratio shows our ability to cover our liabilities in the short term. And for the 2017, it actually went down to 1.41. But our earnings per share went up to $10.21 million. Our dividends per share ratio shows the percentage of the corporation's earnings that were paid as dividends, which has went to 99%. But when it comes to our social responsibility, we actually launched our global program that is called LIFE, and it works towards nine specific different categories. And probably the most important thing is that LVMH aims to reduce its carbon emissions from its own operations by 25%. But so far, we actually haven't achieved a spectacular success.
Salvatore Ferragamo is an Italian luxuries company which specializes in the making of leather belt and shoes. Their strategy is to build a strong relationship with customers by increasing the brand's power. The revenue has been decreasing since 2016, while there is a 3.1% decline in 2017. The gearing is 0.11, while the level of debt has been reduced over the past 5 years from 26.9 to 6.3 today. Salvador Ferragamo demonstrates good financial performance because their quick ratio is above 1 and in particular it's 1.4. Earnings per share went down and is estimated to be around 66 cents. When it comes to the dividends per share, they have been increasing since 2013 to 2017. When it comes to the corporate social responsibility, Salvador Ferragamo Group has adopted measures to reduce its raw materials and monitor emissions from their energy and water operations. Also, the company is committed to reducing the production of waste and participates in many initiatives that aim to protect the environment.
So, Burberry Group is an iconic British luxury brand with a concentration on apparels, accessories, cosmetics and perfumes. Their strategy is to re-energize product and customer's experience. Compared to last year, Burberry's total equity for 2018 has fallen and the sales revenue has decreased with 1%, reaching 2.733 billion. The gearing is 1.63. But the debt is only 1% of its net worth. And let's mention that for 5 years the debt has been reducing and this indicates stability. Burberry Group shows a very good business financial performance. The quick ratio is increasing every year and currently it's 1.56. Earnings per share has increased with 5.51% compared to last year. Dividends per share have been increasing gradually from 2014 till now, and the net profit rises as well as the company's stability. When it comes to sustainability, the corporation has three policies regarding this issue: chemical management, global environmental policy, and responsible sourcing policy. With the first issue, the company has adopted measures to reduce environmental harm to the minimum by taking the chemicals out of the production. But with the second, it aims to reach zero carbon waste and move entirely to clean renewable energy. And with the third, the products to be made with high quality material that can be recycled and reused. So, it's that.
So, Kering is an international luxury group that is based in Paris, France. Luxury brands like Gucci, Balenciaga, Bottega Veneta, Saint Laurent, etc. Their strategy is technically to operate in the high fashion sphere for watchmaking, jewelry, leather goods. Right now, just three of their brand houses have revenue over $1 billion per year. In the past few years, the gearing ratio has significantly increased. In 2016, it was only 36.5%. Then in 2017, it went down to 24%. And in 2018, it rose back to 50%. With a minimum of $155 per share unit and a maximum of $582, Kering Group has somewhat steady growth in their share price. Their quick ratio is currently 0.73 and it's increasing every year. Their earnings per share are increasing as well. From earnings per unit for $4 in 2016, only for 2 years it rose back with $7. The company has a steady increase in their dividend per share as well. For the last 3 years, which is another indicator that their strategic decision to focus only and solely on luxury goods is working very good. When it comes to corporate responsibility, their strategy is called Caring Clean. It has over 150 different water and energy solutions about the supply chain. So technically, they have decided to go absolutely fossil fuel less and to be 100% clean energy from sustainable sources.
So guys, like I told you, Kering is the top investor option.
Yeah, I guess he is.
Oh well, what can I say? You need to rethink your investments.
I guess we're not going out tonight.
Well, thank you very much, sir.
Let me show you to your table.
Thank you.
Well, guys, I guess that we need to rethink our business strategies and invest more wisely. I think maybe we have to think more about the environment and kind of improve our corporate social responsibility.
Maybe we'll come back next year.
Yeah. And then we'll be the ones that go into that club.
Yeah.
Yeah. See you next year, Karing.
See you next year, Karing.